हेलो एवरीवन, माय नेम इज़ डॉक्टर किंजल पटेल, सेकेंड ईयर रेजिडेंट रेडियोलॉजी डिपार्टमेंट फ्रॉम सिलूसा मेडिकल कॉलेज एंड हॉस्पिटल सुरेंद्रनगर। हियर आई एम प्रेजेंटिंग अ केस फॉर केस ऑफ द वीक सीरीज। हिस्ट्री: अ 32 ईयर ओल्ड प्राइमी ग्रेविड फीमेल विथ 3 months ऑफ एमेनोरिया प्रेजेंटिंग टू आवर डिपार्टमेंट फॉर रूटीन अल्ट्रासोनोग्राफी ANC चेकअप फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम। अल्ट्रासाउंड इमेजेस रिवील्स a defect measuring approx 6.8 mm in umbilicus at cord insertion with herniation of abdominal contents through it in membrane covered pouch. As we can see in these images, the abdominal circumference is seen smaller as compared to herniated pouch. In this ultrasound image, we can see the umbilical cord is seen inserted directly into the herniated pouch. Fetal MRI images shows a large hernial sac protruding through the ventral wall of the abdomen, liver and small bowel elements seen in sac covered by thin membrane. Summarizing all the findings, USG findings reveals defect measuring approx 6.8 mm in umbilicus at cord insertion with herniation of abdominal contents through it in membrane covered pouch. MRI findings reveals a large hernial sac through a ventral wall defect is demonstrated. The liver and small bowel elements can be seen in the sac. The latter is covered by a thin membrane. Post-delivery clinical image shows liver and bowel lobes herniated through the anterior abdominal wall defect, which is covered by thin membrane. Summarizing all the findings, the final diagnosis is midline abdominal wall defect omphalocele. Discussion: abdominal wall defects correspond to a wide spectrum of congenital defects. These affect 6.3 out of 10,000 pregnancies. They represent a heterogeneous group of malformations that share a common feature, the herniation of one or more viscera through the anterior abdominal wall. Omphalocele and gastrocisis are the most frequent abnormalities. An omphalocele arises as a consequence of persistent embryonic extrusion of the developing midgut. Thus, it consists of a midline defect at the level of umbilicus, usually with small bowel loops herniation. The herniation may be composed only of a small bowel or a combination between small bowel loops and another organ such as liver. This defect and content is covered by a membrane that has an outer amniotic and inner peritoneal layers, one of the major differences between omphalocele and gastrocisis. Another characteristic feature is the insertion of umbilical cord into the sac, most commonly at its anterior aspect. Ascites may be present into the sac and at the abdominal cavity. It is a congenital anomaly associated with trisomies 18, 13, 21, coexisting anomalies of midline structures including the heart, sternum, diaphragm and bladder, and also syndromes. Back with Whitman. It's crucial to recognize the omphalocele not only for management of the defect itself but also to be aware and assess additional congenital problems. I would like to thank Dr. Harshal Sah sir, Dr. Nirmala Chudasma ma'am, Dr. Rasesh Vyas sir, Dr. Navin Mehta sir for their endless support and guidance. I would also like to thank my colleagues and seniors for support. Thank you.